party was going on.
No. It's 12 o'clock. So I put some threaded rod in the chuck. This is M8. Drill through to put the remainder of the spikes on. Every 15mm I've put a line, and then using the four-jaw chuck I've marked off, and these are going to alternate. I'll need to drill all these four and two of these. Off camera, because the paint's probably going to come off, I've punch marked each hole and I can use it to reference with this spring centre. And that'll hold it in place while I lock it in the jaws. Through the magic of time, the next clip will be me with this with loads of holes in it, like a holy ball thing. But while you're here, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. And if you look down below in the description, there's my Patreon if you want to support me. See you soon. Oh, actually, it's finished. Turn that down to 14, so I know I'm going to drill out to 14. Luckily I've got these beauties. Join me on the lathe. So what I want to do to make sure this is centre, I slide it onto the drill bit, which I use to drill it out, all the way till the main shaft. And then force it inside the chuck. So I'm going to countersink that first and then drive this base through it. And now we just need to line it up to make sure that the spikes don't get in the way of the butt hole.
To the TIG welder.
So I've just been checking the fitment there. I'm going to have to shim this up slightly so I can TIG around there so the ball doesn't get in way of the catch locking in. I was just going to put wood on there, but I really think that it would look real nice with a little brass spacer. I've got one of these old brass fittings that I can turn down, fit on there, and then when I do the wood I can make it slot into there. So it'll act as a collar for the wood, and it'll just look nice. Bore this out now so there's more room for the wood to slot in, and I've also left the vague threads on there because I thought it looked quite aesthetically pleasing to the eyeballs. I decided to go with some Xyla wood, mainly because I just tried with some different wood and I destroyed it. I'll put the snippet in. So, if this looks dangerous, it's probably because it is. Let me know in the comments. Thank you. That's the handle now finished up and polished up. All I need to do is glue all this in, and then I'll drill a retaining pin which will go through the lump that you saw me add in there. I've also ground loads of notches in this to help the glue bind to it. And I've built a little retaining ring which will sit in there so there's no slop in there when it slots against there. And now you're going to see a little montage of me gluing this up. Forgot to press record when I was gluing this up. Put some gold in the epoxy, which was, as you can see, an absolute mess. And I cut away to try and hide the pin slightly. I quite like the little half moon. Ooh.